everybody. I'm back and we're going to the gym. Super excited. First workout, official workout after about 6-7 weeks off from having two surgeries. And you can go back to those YouTube videos in my breast implant series to learn a little bit more about that. But today I'm training legs because I really shouldn't be doing a lot with my upper body just so that everything can continue healing well. And I wanted to show y'all what we have to get ready for the gym. So, as y'all know, I like to get a little pre-workout supplement in, Recharge from Phoenix Fit. Awesome pre-workout. Everything is natural in it. And the caffeine source is yerba mate extract. I don't do a full scoop because if I do a full scoop, I feel like I'm shooting lightning out of my eyeballs. So I do about a half to three quarter. And we're gonna just dump it right in there. So yeah. So I scooped my pre-workout and I put about 8 ounces of water. Like I said, I'm making a mess. You're gonna shake it up. Drink that on the way to the gym. So my pre-workout is the Recharge, and then I've got my recovery BCAAs, and I'm going to be putting coconut water in there for some carbs. Coconut water has some great electrolytes naturally, and it is natural sugar, so if you're on a lower calorie diet, I don't necessarily recommend it unless you're trying to source all of your carbs around your workout. It's a great option for you. Natural, get some potassium in there too. So I'm gonna be putting a scoop of this in this container so that I can just bring it with me to the gym, not bring the entire container. I hate having all supplements in my bag at once because it makes it really heavy. All right, so just filled up my intro workout with the BCAAs and coconut water, a little bit more water so that I can get, it's probably about 16 ounces total I drink during my workout. Usually on a leg day, I'm not really good about being hydrated, but because I'm still recovering from surgery, that's one of the main reasons I added in the coconut water for more electrolytes to keep me hydrated. And I'm kind of sick. So I'm gonna get started with this workout. I'm gonna have to modify it just a little bit from what I originally was planning to do because we ended up coming to Crunch, my home gym, instead of another gym we were going to go to, but it's gonna be fun either way. Ready to get a pump on, ready to feel good in the gym again. Let's do it. So I'm starting off with some Bosu ball. We're gonna do regular glute bridges to get the glutes activated and warmed up. I'm doing like a full leg kind of workout today. I really wanna activate my hamstrings, my glutes. I feel like that's the weakest part of my physique right now. So probably gonna do 3 sets of 20, 4 sets of 20, see how that goes. Shorter of a rest. That way I'm really keeping that blood flow going, muscle activation, especially because I've taken so much time off. I think it'll help kickstart my metabolism. I am trying to do a little bit of a cut right now, getting ready for a wedding in about a month. So, like I said, just keeping my heart rate moving, blood flow going. It's probably gonna be about an hour of a workout, including rest, but I'm definitely gonna focus on some stretching today. Because now that I haven't worked out in a while, I gotta keep my flexibility up. So I did 2 sets of 20 using my body weight only, and now I'm gonna use a 15-pound kettlebell, see how that feels, give me a little bit more activation going that way. sometimes it's nice to just try out a different weight. Otherwise, body weight's good too. You gotta figure out what works for you. So I'm just gonna place it on my pelvis. So here's the second movement. We're gonna do barbell hip thrust. And I use like a 12 inch or a 14 inch platform against a pole. That way I'm out of everybody's way, and since I'm not going super heavy, I'm doing a 40 pound dumbbell with this pad so that my pelvis doesn't die. So I'll show you guys. I try and line up in the center here, and then we're gonna roll it back. Literally similar movement to the glute bridge, but you're gonna be able to focus more on that middle glute. So I'm gonna set it on my hips here. You want your feet back a little bit closer to you and your feet more narrow. About hips width or a little bit closer together. Your back, you want your shoulders to be pressed against this platform. That way, when you're going up, you're able to flex right in that medial and maximal. Fitting, doing legs. There's like nobody in the gym. Pretty great. Oh, there's Bay over there. Too bad I couldn't zoom in on him. Oh, here we go. This is like creeper mode. He's one of my favorites to watch in gym though. So intense. All right. Enough goofing around. This is serious. So serious. Let's not do that. So be careful. Can't breathe. It's a good sign. Ooh. It's funny because I actually don't feel this as much as I did the glute bridges. So another note is as you're doing different movements for specific body parts, really notice which ones you get activation from. Start adding those in more because odds are that's where you're getting your growth from. So I decided I'm doing one heavy compound today, and that is going to be the pit shark. And if you guys don't have a pit shark at your gym, try and find something you can do this with, whether it's a squat or a Smith machine. This is the machine. So essentially you attach a belt down here to your waist, and you can squat, you can lunge, basically anything that you would want to do in a squat rack, you can do. So pretty awesome. I don't know what I'm going to do for weight yet, but I'm probably going to have to recruit David to put it on for me. Alright, so this belt went around my waist. Chain. Flip it on wherever you need it. Depends on your height, how far of range of motion you're trying to get. I usually like a pretty good range of motion, so I'm going to make it pretty tight. Now I attach to the machine. Now I use my legs to lift up the weight. And there's a handle that you can set the weight to if you need to re-rack. You can do that. Slow down, fast up. Tempo can make a huge difference in your workout intensity. So I suggest playing around with that if you're worried about going up in a weight, especially if you're working out by yourself, like a lot of women tend to do. So try that next time. Probably gonna do 4 sets, 8 to 10 reps, to be honest, and go from there. Hello, what's your name?
My name is Ian.
Oh, I knew you were gonna do that. This is David, for those who haven't met him. David's doing a heavy, heavy leg day. I love the hack squat, but why are you using the hack squat today?
So, usually I have a training partner, we do squats together. And I've been progressively using 455 as my weight tolerance. This week I try to shoot for an extra 2 reps every week. So I started at 3 reps, that was my 455, but this is my third day back after surgery. Then the next week I was shooting for 5, I ended up getting 4. Didn't get good sleep the night before, but then I was going to go back this week and shoot for another six at 455, basically over the time. Well, not with my workout partner today because of the bad weather. So 6 plates is actually where I left off, where it felt very, very heavy for me. And I just did 5 plates of feeling very light. First day back to it. So I'm going to be overloading with this if I can't make it over that gym when I can.
So why do you like the hack squat? What part of the leg does it work?
It works the quad more so than the hamstrings, but I go very deep with it just like a squat. But the difference is that your knees pass very far over your knees very comfortably. So you can get a lot of volume on your quads without it just blowing out your kneecaps like you could on a squat. It's very hard to pack your knees very far over your knees, or very far over your feet without injuring you.
Yay, so no blown out knees.
No blown out knees.
But big legs.
Maybe.
Big legs.
One
minute. Mine are baby legs now, and you can't see his because he's got sweatpants on. Superset with frog pumps, supersetted with calf raises. So it's literally a Triset. Feels really good at the end of the workout, and I'm gonna sauna, try and get some of the sickness out of me and go from there.